everyone. It's John.
And Ben.
And Ben, do you remember the Disney store?
I do. It's been a long time, but I do remember the Disney store.
It's back in mini brands form.
If we get to go to Disney, at least it's, you know, it's right here. It'll be in our house. The Disney store will be in our house.
Our action figures can shop at the Disney store. We may not be able to go to a physical Disney store anywhere near us, but they made a Disney store mini brands. We opened a ton of these capsules, but not on YouTube. We didn't do a traditional YouTube video. I don't know why not, but we posted a bunch of them on
Instagram Reels.
Yeah. Instatalk.
Instatalk. Somewhere on TikTok, yes.
You're probably watching a little compilation of them right now. And we had so many, we didn't even mind getting doubles because we were going to make our own little mini Disney store. We probably should have known one was coming because mini brands did their own little toy store and their own little grocery store.
I don't remember seeing a Peter Pan.
Maybe that's one of the exclusive ones in this box. You're getting ahead of us.
I know, but I was looking at all of them on the front here while you were talking, and I don't remember a Peter Pan.
We almost got all of them. I think we were missing just a handful. Ben will let us know which ones we were missing. You know, just looking at the box, this seems like a pretty accurate recreation of a Disney store. I am disappointed. When we were going to do our custom Disney store, we were going to have, in the back of the store, the big monitor and the tiered display of plushies.
Yeah, we were going to make our own Disney store just like this, but in 90s style. And we had blueprints and everything of what we were going to do, but this came out faster. So
the screen, we were going to leave like a spot big enough to put like an iPod or a cell phone into.
Yeah.
Let's open this up. We found it at Target, $30. It comes with 5 minis to unbox, 2 exclusive minis. We see a little tiny Ray down here. I guess we should explain. I guess everybody who watches this channel knows what a mini brand is,
right? Oh yeah, they have to.
All right, we don't need to go into
that. They just saw me open 20 of them while you were talking. They know.
Comes with all like the little shelving units and the cash register. Oh, very nice. So while Ben is opening it, this is our stash. This is our stash of Disney mini brands. Like we said, we didn't mind getting the extras. Look how cute these are, guys. We should have done a video for you guys on these a long time ago. Got little animator dolls. We got little Star Wars figures. We even got some exclusives like this golden Forky.
There's our checklist.
Because we were going to stock the shelves of our own custom Disney store.
We were.
You know, and who knows, maybe if this goes on clearance, we'll buy another one so we can customize it to be the 80s Disney store with a neon sign.
That'd be fun.
So we do have stickers to apply. Everything looks like a big blind bag.
It does. One more bag in here. There we go.
Oh man, where to begin? This must be
the instructions. Yeah.
Nice to see a toy company including very detailed instructions on how to put their thing together.
I very much appreciate it, mini brands. Thank you.
They have an unfolded checklist.
Ooh, see this. Very nice.
All right, now which one has the toys for us to unbox?
This checklist is different than that one.
Yeah, I saw you put the box on the floor. Don't forget to take Ray out of there.
I won't. This checklist is different than the one that we've been getting in the balls, because this one includes some figures.
I dropped it. I don't want to lose it. So I opened up this tiny bag right here and pulled out a little Bo Peep Pixar toy box figure, that must be another exclusive one. That must be the other exclusive. So I'm going to guess the toys are in the little tiny bags. So,
well, you can open the toys because I opened most of the balls. So you can open those.
You let me and Tegan help with a couple of them.
I did.
Oh, here's Peter Pan right here.
And Ray. This is exciting.
So we got Ray, Bo Peep, Peter Pan.
Thor.
Oh, and we got a golden guitar.
Oh, from Coco.
It says Rapunzel.
Oh, I thought it was Coco. But okay.
We'll go with that.
Those are all new mini brands. Yes. Because this checklist is new. If you look at the old checklist you put back over there, you'll notice that these five are not on there. So I don't know why it says two exclusive. They're all, unless they're going to be part of series two.
I don't know.
That may or may not be coming. We don't know.
Yeah, all five of those are new to us. Sweet. Yeah. Yeah, the only two that we're missing, we never got Bullseye. I'll have you put the picture up on the screen. We never got Bullseye, and we never got the other set of the little paper bags.
Yeah.
I mean, no big deal about that, but Oh man, how did we not get Bullseye?
I don't know. We never got them. I'm going to tear these bags open now.
And there were three golden ones.
Yeah, the golden ones, but I didn't count those.
Yeah.
Oh, shelves.
Oh, jeez.
I don't know if you could even see that. This is gonna be fun. You guys know how I love putting things together.
Yeah, this is gonna be a time lapse.
More. Oh, this is probably part of the.
Yeah, you probably don't want to open up all the bags yet because I bet.
It doesn't have numbers on it.
Oh, okay. I didn't know if they had them numbered like Legos.
I don't see numbers. I'll keep them separate.
Oh, this is gonna look so good when it's all together. But yeah, I'm disappointed there was no monitor that you'd put in built in somewhere.
I know. I have my job to do, so let's put this together.
First time seeing the Disney store all assembled, and it's adorable.
It is. It's very adorable.
I want to shrink down and walk around in it.
I know. It's a lot of fun, and there's a lot that's even hard to get the camera in so that you can see it properly. You know, like, it's so tight quarters in there that it's very hard to show you on the camera how good it looks from all angles. It's very hard. I do really like this. I do have a couple complaints, though.
Okay, go for it.
Okay. My first complaint is that the size of these shelves really should be a little bit bigger, because in order to get the bigger items to fit on the bottom, this middle shelf here has to be so high that, and then this one is only has a little bit. So nothing really fits on these middle shelves. Very few of the items fit down there.
And also be aware that some of the things don't stay on the shelves very well. Bin used some of the, you know, this tacky poster sticky stuff that help hold stuff down.
The only ones that are not held down are these Star Wars ones. And you can see how easy they kind of jumble around. They all need to be stuck down. All the other ones are stuck down. And we can also see that it's kind of hard, like a weird scale. The toys themselves, I think, work well with like a Barbie scale. But then you put them in the store is a lot smaller than that. So Barbie's scale wouldn't work in the store.
She'd be like a giant.
Yeah. And these little Disney princesses, they look good with the shelves, but the toys look huge. So it's really a weird scale for the store itself.
And the Disney princess display, it's a really cute idea. I like the castle, but I don't know if I'm a fan of how the dolls, like, you crammed them into the top, but I don't know what else you would put up there.
There are zero toys in this line that fit in the middle of the castle. I just have an empty hole there. It would be good if I could put the fashion dolls in that hole, but I can't. And I have so many of these fashion dolls that through the middle of the door of the castle, they are lined all the way out to the back. You just can't see it from the front.
But these are just minor complaints.
Yeah.
I mean, a tiny scale Disney store isn't going to be exactly perfect.
No. But I do love it.
Overall, it is very good. It's a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun to collect these.
Yeah.
Hopefully there's a season two, maybe.
There has to be, because we still have room in here. You know, we have some empty shelves, and this section right here, there's room for two more of the square shelves that we just don't have.
So after the holidays, if there's a holiday sale on another Disney store,
yeah,
would you buy another one to like to put them side by side?
Yes, that would be fun.
And then maybe you could make my little screen and mountain of plush from the classic era Disney store.
Yeah, that would be fun to do.
Because on YouTube, maybe you can put in a clip as I'm talking, but I've found on YouTube somebody has uploaded some video loops from the early 2000 Disney store screens.
Yes.
So find a way to put that on your phone. Just stick your phone behind the pile of plush and boom.
Yeah.
We're going to have to do that. So if there's a season two of these, hold us to that. We definitely want to do it.
For sure.
You're crafty. I'm sure you could figure out a way to get a tiered shelf of plushes.
Oh, yeah. I could figure it out.
So that's going to wrap up our look at the Tiny Disney Store. You can find this at Target. We bought this, all of this, if you can believe it, with our own money. You can be the judge if this was money well spent or not.
There are probably more important things you should have been spending our money on, but this is fun, and this brings us joy.
We'll see you next time, everybody.
Bye.